What's happening, gang? Matt Martin with Vehement Knives. Just stopped in over at DLT Trading, and we wanted to do a quick little video on what, to our amazement, has become our best-selling model, and that is the Vehement Knives Grunt EDC. And I tell you what, it's 316 CPM 154, and we designed this, I would say probably close to 4 years ago, if maybe not a little bit over 4 years ago. And it was an answer to, at that point, what was kind of a price point EDC that we had out that had virtually no ergonomics to it whatsoever. And we wanted to add a little bit of flair to it, a little bit more user friendly features, you know, that kind of thing. So we drew this up. I drew this up back in those days. It was pretty much just me. Jenna was answering the phone, but the design and everything like that was just on my bench. So I drew this up, and bam, fast forward 4 years later, we've got hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of them out in the world, and we're really excited about it. We just were astonished that it was such a successful design, but it has undergone some changes over the years. So from 01 to whatever number, we're well over 400 now, there have been some modifications. And in fact, every batch we put out, I try to add one more little feature to it to make it either a little bit more aesthetically pleasing, a little bit higher performing, or a little bit more comfortable in the hand. And in some cases, we even got some help from some local sheath makers on new carry options. We'll get into those in just a minute. So in my hand right now is number 456, and I grabbed it because this is one of my personal favorite color combinations. That's olive drab green micarta canvas micarta, with red vulcanized fiber liners. So it just has a really neat aesthetic to it. This one is in our satin tiger lips finish, which is basically an acid treatment that's kind of reminiscent of the Vietnam era tiger stripe camouflage pattern. Now, we do it in a subdued and in a satin. So when you see these, don't mistake it for Damascus, because it is through and through pure performing CPM 154 stainless steel. And we like it that way out of the mono steel, because we feel like for a user, you just get a lot more performance features out of it. So let me just go over a couple of changes that have been applied to the Grunt over the past half a decade. And that is probably first and foremost, and one of my favorites, is the polished and radiused forward finger choil. So in this area right here, it's really kind of a buttery smooth feeling to it. So when you do choke up forward of the grip of the self-guard here, it's just, your finger wants to rest there, and it's very comfortable. No hot spots, no little blisters as you're using it. Another thing that we've changed over the years is gonna be the edge thickness. So we've had these ground, and I grind these much thinner now. If you go back to number one, you'll see it's kind of an obtuse edge. I was still kind of cutting my teeth as a maker back at that point. So we have thinned out the edge significantly. The other thing we've changed is I've knocked the corners on the jimping down significantly. So there you'll have like a little faceted look, which gives some visual aesthetic, but it also, when you place your thumb on that jimping for that added purchase, you also don't get hot spots. So it just allows the flesh of your thumb, the pad of your thumb, to press in there, give that extra grip, but without being a cheese grater and really eating you up. I would say the final feature that we've added to this to improve the design overall, at least in our opinion from functionality standpoint, is the brass lanyard tube in the back. Previously, there was no tube there in the first renditions, and we added this to reinforce this kind of small band of micarta back here, because we were noticing that some of them were chipping out. Since we've added the tube, we've had no such problems. So obviously that fix worked. Now, let's get to the good part. This is probably going to be our last batch of Grunts of this type, because we're really looking forward to the future of this model, and because it was such a huge success, we're having a hard time meeting the demand. So we're going to move into some full production models of the Grunt, and in that we're going to do some a little bit larger, we're going to do some in this size but a little bit thinner, and then hopefully, and this isn't entirely cast in stone yet, but we're thinking about doing some fuller versions and maybe even some subtle profile changes. So that's the kind of thing you can keep your eyes out for the Grunt in the coming future. So I really appreciate all your guys' support. I appreciate you guys supporting Vehement Knives and DLT Trading. And stay tuned, because you never know what the next version of the Grunt is going to be. Thanks so much for watching, gang. Live vehemently.